Welcome back, everyone. Today I have this 3x3 shutter door for you, which closes like this and opens like this. As you can see, it's quite fast. It's not the smallest design, but I think the speed makes up for it. So yeah, let's just show you how to make this. Alright, so this should be everything you will need to build the door. And we will start by placing in our door frame, which will be right in the center. And you will need a two block gap below. So just place it in like this, and we can start placing in the layout. So you will need a single extender here, another one here, and then one here. Now we place our double extenders, which will be folded. So the first one goes like this, the second one like this, another one here. And the last one on this side, like this. And then we just have a normal double extender in the middle, on top, like this. And that's your layout. And now we will start by hooking up the single extenders. So your input block will be right here, which also powers the first one. And you place blocks like this. And then some slabs, like this. And a block here. And on this side we place three blocks like this, two slabs here, and then an immovable block that's not transparent here, slab here, and another one here, and then just dust on everything we just placed, like this. And if we flick on the lever, they extend, except for this one. What we need to do here is redirect the dust so it points into this piston, or just place any redirector. Alright. And now we can move on to the folded extenders. So what we need to do first is power these back pistons after three ticks. So for this one, we come down here, place two blocks like this, with dust on top. We take a hopper, which we place right here. And then three observers like this. For this one, we actually replace this block with an observer pointing downwards, with dust on top. And then two more like this into a block. For this on top, we just come out from this dust with an observer, and then two more like this. And for this one, we place two observers, block here, an observer pointing down, and a hopper here, and just replace this. So what we need to do next is power these pistons that push in the folded piston after three ticks as well. So for this one, we just place a block, another block, and a three tick repeater. But we actually need to update it, because at three ticks it actually can't push. So we add another repeater and one tick here. We take a normal piston, which we place right here, and then an observer pointing into the air block below this piston, and then just replace this. Alright, so for the top one, we place two blocks like this, repeater and one tick, and dust. And two more blocks like this, two tick repeater, which will power this block, which but powers this piston, and just place another block to update it. And then we also need to place some observers like this. Alright, so on the bottom, place a repeater like this, into a block with dust. Two more blocks like this, two tick repeater, another dust, another block. And then we actually need to lock this on the opening. So we place a torch here, and a 3D repeater like this. And we can also place a block here, because this dust will also power this block for the piston that gets pushed in to grab the block. Alright, so that should almost be it for the folded doubles. We just need to place a block here, slab, dust, and a repeater, another block. And for this one we need a middle extender to control a bit of it, so we can't test it right now. But we can test the others, so let's just close it. As you can see, they are all working. And for this one, we just need the middle extender, so we start with that right now. Alright, so from these two slabs, we come out and place two more, with dust on top. Place a repeater on three ticks, and an observer like this. And then behind this repeater, place a piston and a block. And now we need a comparator and any container, basically. You place like this, and an item inside. And what this will do is on the closing, because the piston needs to extend, we get some bit of extra delay before this powers, with just enough so it works. And then opening it will instantly start to retract, and this will instantly unpower, so we basically get different delays on the closing and opening. Alright, so next up we place an observer coming out from a double like this, and now we go up here with dust and a comparator here and another observer like this. Now we place a block here with dust and then a target block here. And now a sticky piston, a normal piston like this, an observer here, and then a hopper like this, and a block here. And this will actually create a zero tick on the opening so that the first retraction is fully synced. And now all that's left is two blocks like this, dust, just fix this, and a repeater on one tick like this, and a block here. And this should actually already be the door. So let's just test it right now. Closes and it opens. So just fill in the door frame and we are done. One more thing though, if you want a more traditional shutter animation where the first rotation isn't synced, actually just change it a little bit, but it will be slower. So what we need to do is just replace, break this, set this to 4, replace it, and then just remove this and place the observer here. And this gives you the normal animation where the middle is behind basically. But I think the faster animation is really nice, so let me just replace this like so. And yeah, that's the door. I hope you enjoyed this video and thank you for watching.